Good morning and welcome to St. Albans Episcopal Church. Wherever you are watching, whether at home or in the comfort of your home, I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I pray that you can experience God's peace in this moment, the peace which surpasses all human understandings. Because of COVID-19 conditions in Houston, we continue to live stream our worship services. If you are joining for the first time, a very special welcome to you. My name is Father Greg Semi, and I am the new interim vicar here at St. Albans. Today is officially my first Sunday here. I am glad to be here with you. A special thanks to the technicians who have and will continue to help us broadcast our live stream services. This morning, I would like to thank especially Ms. Gwen, who is here with us at this service as our technician. We would also like to thank Ms. Rosa Osegueda for the flowers at the altar today, given to the glory of God in the honor of Eduardo and Jose on their birthday celebrations. Father Bill and Cherry would like to thank everyone for their cards, donations, and participations in joining them for their retirement party. Remember that we are here to serve you. Don't hesitate to communicate with us either by phone or by email to inform us how we can be there for you and your family members, especially in these difficult moments. Our contact information can be found in the church webpage. Now, supporting the ministries at St. Albans is more important than ever before. You can offer your gift by going to our webpage at www.stalbanseepiscopalhouston.org and click on the e-give button located almost in the bottom of the page. You can also call the office or drop by the office to offer your donation. This week, we received three envelopes with offerings. We are asking God's blessings upon those who send their pledges either online or to the office. We also pray that the Lord can provide to those who would like to contribute, but are unable to do so at this time. Thank you to those who have supported St. Albans financially and otherwise, and would like to remind you of the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, who himself said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." Sisters and brothers in Christ, allow me to use the words of the psalmist, which says, "This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it." Again, thank you for joining us, and I am glad that you are here. Now, let us prepare ourselves to worship the Lord as we begin with the opening hymn, "Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven."
Oh,
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen. Let us say now together the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. O God, because without you, we are not able to please you, mercifully grant that your Holy Spirit may in all things direct and rule our hearts. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for our reading.
The reading is from Romans chapter 14, beginning with verse 1. Welcome those who are weak in faith, but not for the purpose of quarreling over opinions. Some believe in eating anything, while the weak eat only vegetables. Those who eat must not despise those who abstain, and those who abstain must not pass judgment on those who eat, for God has welcomed them. Who are you to pass judgment on servants of others? It is before their own Lord that they stand or fall, and they will be upheld. For the Lord is able to make them stand. Some judge one day to be better than another, while others judge all days to be alike. Let all be fully convinced in their own minds. Those who observe the day, observe it in honor of the Lord. And those who eat, eat in honor of the Lord, since they give thanks to God. And those who abstain, abstain in honor of the Lord and give thanks to God. We do not live to ourselves, and we do not die to ourselves. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, so that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why do you pass judgment on your brother or sister? Or why do you despise your brother or sister? For we all stand before the judgment seat of God, for it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us will be accountable to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Okay, Psalm. Hallelujah, when Israel came out of Egypt.
The house of Jacob from a people of strange speech.
Judah became God's sanctuary.
And Israel his dominion.
The sea beheld it and fled.
Jordan turned and went back.
The mountains skipped like rams.
And the little hills, the young sheep.
What ailed you, O sea, that you fled?
O Jordan, that you turned back.
You mountains, that you skipped like rams.
You little hills, like young sheep.
Tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord.
At the presence of God of Jacob.
Who turned the hard rock into a pool of water? The word of the Lord.
Please stand as we sing our sequential hymn, O bless the Lord, my soul.
O bless the Lord, my soul.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew.
Praise to you, Lord.
Peter came and said to Jesus, Lord, if another member of the church sins against me, how often should I forgive? As many as 7 times? Jesus said to him, not 7 times, but I tell you, 77 times. For this reason, the kingdom of heaven may be compared to a king who wished to settle accounts with his slaves. When he began to reckon him, one who owed him 10,000 talents was brought to him. And as he could not pay, his lord ordered him to be sold, together with his wife and children and all his possessions, and payment to be made. So the slave fell on his knees before him, saying, have patience with me, and I will pay you everything. And out of pity for him, the lord of that slave released him and forgave him the debt. But that same slave, as he went out, came upon one of his fellow slaves who owed him 100 denarii. And seizing him by the throat, he said, pay what you owe. Then his fellow slave fell down and pleaded with him, have patience with me, and I will pay you. But he refused. Then he went and threw him into prison until he would pay the debt. When his fellow slaves saw what had happened, they were greatly distressed, and went and reported to their lord all that had taken place. Then his lord summoned him and said to him, you wicked slave, I forgave you all that debt because you pleaded with me. Should you not have had mercy on your fellow slave as I had mercy on you? And in anger, his lord handed him over to be tortured until he would pay his entire debt. So my heavenly Father will also do to every one of you if you do not forgive your brother or sister from your heart. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please pray with me and for me. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be always acceptable in your sight, O God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. It is an honor and a privilege to be with you today. Thank you for your prayers. You have also been in mine. I hope that in the days and weeks to come, we can get to know one another better with respect to social distancing, of course. Again, I am excited to be here as your interim vicar in preparation for a new chapter in the history of St. Albans. The letter of St. Paul to the Romans offers us solace, and I hope that you find solace in your faith's journey. St. Paul and his message to the community not only offers comfort, but also calls us to action to overcome the challenges and obstacles of life today. A challenge to change, to grow and to transform this community into the image of the risen Christ. A challenge to acknowledge that only God has the right to all final judgments, for only He knows and sees it all. You and I only see half of the picture. We cannot see the hearts of men. We cannot hear the secret thoughts of those sitting next to us, let alone across the street. You and I are fallible, emotional, and yes, at times biased and impressionable. What kind of final verdicts will we hand out when we are so limited? God sees what was, what is, and what will be. We are assured that God's final judgment will be flawless. It will be free of any partiality. Our passage from Romans asks us to be prepared for the day that we as Christians shall meet our judgment by the one and only true judge, our Lord Jesus Christ, the way we must give account and be evaluated for what we have done as believers. So today, my sisters and brothers, I want to ask you, how have you been living your best Christian life? Have you been loving and kind to your neighbors, especially those on the margins of our society? Have you been extending the grace that the Lord has given you to others? Have you been doing Christianity? Yes, doing Christianity as in action. I cannot stop thinking of when I was a child, and I have done things that I knew my parents would disapprove of, and they were sure to find out about. I felt terrible, the anxiety and fear of what will happen when they called on it were worse than the actual punishment most of the times. I often wanted to confess so I can get to the punishment part. The wedding and guilt were so much worse. Whatever the punishment, whatever the disobedience was, my parents would not let me change my last name. I would still have a roof over my head and food to eat. Likewise, when we repent to God, He does not turn His back on us. He never gives us what we truly deserve, because if so, many of us will not be here today. Please, brothers and sisters, take a moment and remember the many things and many times we cried out to God for forgiveness, and where we would be if He did not pardon us over and over again. In the Lord's Prayer, we always ask God to forgive us as we forgive others. Today, my question for you is, how can we learn from God's forgiveness? How much, when, and whom can we forgive? Our forgiveness is tied to how we forgive others. Now, let us ask ourselves, who are we not to be able to forgive and accept a neighbor for the perceived flaws? How can we hold back on the things we ask the Lord for the most? Forgiveness, acceptance, and love. How can we do Christianity without those things? Someday, we will give an account to the Lord, even though we know that we will still join Him in heaven to be with Him forever. He will not disown us. Yet, we still have to render an account And the thing in this passage we are going to report on is the people that we have differences with, those we've been judging, the things we have done, and those we have left undone. The way we treated those we have differences of opinion with. If we are harsh against them and judgmental and condemning them, we will be held accountable for that. Because extended love, grace, and mercy in the body of Christ are essential to Jesus. Believe it or not, someday, each one of us will stand before God, and God will look at you and me in the eye, and He will ask us, as Christians, tell me exactly what you have done while on earth. And we have to render an account of what we have done. I believe that should make us stop and make us think twice about living a more sanctified life in the power of the Spirit to please God and to try to stay away from sin. It is terrifying to me, the idea of appearing before God for judgment, because even though I am a child of God, I have to tell him everything I did. It doesn't matter if it is terrible or scary. Notice, God's judgment is wrapped up in His love, tied up with grace, and with a bow of mercy on top. Friends, we still have time to get right with the Lord. So if you hear the voice of God whispering to you today, do not harden your heart. Simply listen to Jesus' call and respond to it, even if it is uncomfortable. That is the right thing to do. Discomfort brings about change and growth. It is the call to love, the call to extend God's grace, and the call to understand that we are not placed in this world to judge, but instead to love and help our neighbor. How wonderful it is to know that Jesus is our judge and that we are called to love because Jesus Christ first loves us. The good news is that Christ loves us not because of anything that we do, but rather in spite of all the terrible things that we do. Beloved in Christ, act like today is Judgment Day and that you have no other time to prepare yourself to stand before the Lord. What would you say to the Lord? Would you be able to say that you love your neighbor as yourself? Would you say that you have been gracious and loving even to those that are not so lovable? What will stand in the way of you being able to say that you have lived as a believer and have done Christianity every day? Please make a note of what is holding you back and start changing them today, at this time. You see, I come to you today as a stranger, but I hope to be a friend and better yet, a brother in Christ to each one of you soon. It is my solemn prayer that all those who enter this space do so with the goal of growing our spiritual family tree. I also pray that the Holy Spirit guides us so that we can be agents of grace in our community and in the world. Guided by the Holy Spirit, we can extend the grace of God to those around us so that through us, those we encounter can experience God's love, forgiveness, and grace on earth, this day and always. Amen. Now let us stand and let us affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The prayers of the people, form 6. In peace, we pray to you, Lord God. For all people in their daily life and work,
for our families, friends, and neighbors,
and for those who are alone,
for Lindell Park and Houston, the nation and the world,
for all who work for justice, freedom, and peace,
for the just and proper use of your creation, for the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression, for all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble, for those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy, for the peace and unity of the Church of God, for all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth, for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, for our bishops, Andy, Jeff, Hector, and Kay, for our interim vicar, Greg, and for all bishops and other ministers, for all who serve God and His church, for the special needs and concerns of this congregation. Today we pray for healing for Elsa, for Vicky, Abigail, for Dr. Eloy, for Sylvia, for Maria, for Rosa, for Nicole, for iStar Senior Living, for Maria, for Will, for Josefina, for Mercedes, and for all the families affected by the virus. Also, we pray for those in long-term needs, especially for Susan, for Duke, for Irby, for Maria, for Jennifer, for Benson, for Rebecca, for Teofilo, for Marta, Catherine, Yanis, and Tina. We pray for the Psalms member, especially for Mike, Kim, Liliana, Catherine, and Monette. We pray for our Bishop's Committee members, especially for Alejandra, for Calvin, for Elsa, for Gwen, and for Mercedes. Remember our soldiers, especially Ryan, Alejandra, and Ashley. You may add your own petitions at this time. Hear us, Lord, for your mercy is great. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessing of this life. Especially today, we pray for the birthdays of Eduardo and Jose. We give thanks also for Isabel, Walter, Eric, and Jose, who are celebrating their birthdays today, this week I mean. We may add your own petition and thanksgiving at this time. We will exalt you, O God, our King. We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Especially today we pray for the repose of the soul of Humberto E. Ramirez. May he and all who have died rest in peace through the mercy of God. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them who put their trust in you. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Most merciful Father, in your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so help us all by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Now, my sisters and brothers, the peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Now, walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Now we will stand and sing our final hymn, Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of Creation. Life is short, and we do not have time to gladden the hearts and minds of those who travel the way with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind. May the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and with those you love, today and forevermore. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Again, thank you for joining us, and have a blessed week.
Father Greg,
introduce your family. All right. Yes. All right, since we are here, let's just take the time to invite my family members to come here so you guys can meet them. Although one of them, the youngest one, could not be here with us, but at least I have three of them here with me. Let us go. Here they are. We have my wife, Mary, and Ashley, and Mishaina. So Alicia, the youngest one, she's 11 months old right now, but she couldn't be here with us. But I'm sure she might be watching in her sleep. Oh, and again, thank you. And it is an honor to be with all of you. And we look forward to getting to know all of you. Thank you, and God bless.
God bless.